Y'all, it's your girl Stace in the place. Welcome back to Candle Chronicles.
Wow.
Candle Chronicles episode 26. Can you tell them it's episode 26? Today we are going to go through, let's see, this is 4, 8, 11. We're going to go through at least 11 candle crates. So grab a snack, a little glass of adult juice, if you will. Well, actually, no, it's too early in the morning for that, unless it's a mimosa. Wait, why are you trying to hit me? So these guys were like patiently chilling in the chair until I like saw this fly. I don't know why, but like flies are a thing out here in South Carolina. Wild. And so I hit it with my shoe and it startled them. So they're all like, ooh, right now. So don't mind them and their tippy-tappies. But here's the perfect Christmas. This one, again, just an easy grab, easy gifting scent. This one was one that, it came in one of those, like, holiday boxes, but then it started, like, showing up for 75% off because I assumed that people were picking it up and then picking up the box because the boxes are a great deal if you can get them with a coupon after a little while when they're, like, on sale. Great deal. And then, you know, if you don't care for the candle, then you exchange the candle and then these kept popping up. So we're going to put this one in the backup pile because y'all know and have seen a whole lot of the perfect Christmases. Let me grab this little girl of terror. I'm going to put her up there. I let them go out and play today, but they're rambunctious. You rambunctious today? Yeah? You had a nap and now you're just ready? It's on and popping? Next up is Under the Christmas Tree, another tried and true beautiful Christmas scent. I love this packaging. I love gold, baby. Anything with gold, that's where I'm at. So backup pile, we've seen that one. I think this is another one, of course. This candle, just in case you're wondering, you see it in the bucket. This is leaves from the last time. So it's just chilling in there, waiting for the backup pile to get moved over there. Oh, tis the season. So this one, it's not bad. It's very cinnamony. It's what I would think that Christmas cider smells like. And if I had to choose, was it Christmas cider? Yeah, I think it's called Christmas cider. It's one of the cider ones. It's not spiced apple toddy because that one is just, no thank you. but 'tis the season is what I would imagine that a Christmas cider kinder would smell like. This one's cute with the little reindeers, but it's not one of my faves. So back up pile so we can use that sucker up. But who is one of my faves right here is Little Cozy Cashmere. Oh, this was such cute packaging. And it was wild because there really wasn't a lot of these. I don't know about, but oh, it smells so good. But I'm gonna put it in the backup pile because we've seen this one before. Cozy cashmere, beautiful, like linen, clean smelling scent, just chef's kiss. Also, I have been using up my laundry detergent because y'all told me don't even fool around and get the scent beads, like just leave it alone. So I've been using it up. I have one of those washing machines where like you can just pour the container full of the washing liquid and stuff and just let it do its thing. So it's been doing its thing. I haven't had to refill or do anything. So I feel like when I take the clothes out of the washer and get ready to put them in the dryer, I can smell like the faint smell of cozy cashmere, but it's not enough for me to purchase again. So yeah. Here's another 'tis the season. So we're just gonna put this one in the backup pile. I'm trying to be a little bit faster because we gotta get through these before Thanksgiving. And I've already, I don't know if you see it, but I brought the tree downstairs. So like after we finish this pile over here, which I think we have 35 crates over here. I don't know how many crates are left here. I'm hoping that we can get through them by Thanksgiving. Like, I don't know. Do you guys mind the long form videos, or maybe I should just record more videos and put them out like maybe more frequently. I don't know. We'll have to figure it out. I really want to like have most of it all done by Thanksgiving, so then we can put up the tree and like enjoy and live life. But yeah, I don't know. We'll see. But let's hustle. See, I'm already talking your ear off. Okay. Pink, lilac, and vanilla. Oh, this one's so pretty. It's like a floral that anyone could love. It's nice. It's pretty. This one is fresh lilac bouquet, dewy greens, and vanilla balsam. I think it must be the vanilla balsam or the dewy green. Probably more the vanilla, because vanilla tends to tone things down, but it tones down the lilac in a way that you can like actually enjoy it and not feel like you're in a chokehold with like a bunch of flowers somewhere. So really enjoy that. Lemon lavender shortbread. This one's so pretty. This one is so good. This is like a fossil. I have not seen this one in a long time. This one was 2021. It is sugared shortbread, zested lemons, and fresh lavender sprinkles. I'm a sucker for lavender, like clearly, so yeah. But I believe we've seen this one, so I'm gonna put this in the backup pile. Trying to be better about the cereal and cartoons. I feel like we've talked about cereal and cartoons before. It just smells like Cinnamon Toast Crunch, aka my favorite, all-time favorite cereal. I need to get my little self out to the grocery store or to Target, because they have gingerbread toast crunch. Like the Cinnamon Toast Crunch people made a gingerbread version. Now, y'all know I love me some gingerbread, so I'm definitely gonna have to get my hands on that. But it's like $5.49. I was like, since when is cereal the price of, like, over the price of a Happy Meal? Like, what are we doing? And we all know that the cereal is not healthy. So I'm just like, make it make sense. Lord, it's a mess. I've been waiting for a sale, but of course it hasn't gone on sale at Target. So yeah. Oh, and another thing I'm looking for, just like random side note, I like see the container and everything. It's ice cream. Bluebell, the Bluebell eggnog ice cream. When I tell y'all, if I see it, I'm buying two, because when I tell you that eggnog ice cream just like takes me to another level. And then I love to like eat it whenever my husband is going out of town, so like I could just eat it, go for it. And if I get lactose unhappy, it's fine. I mean, the dogs might look at me a little funny, but like, other than that, I'm living my best eggnog life. Okay, so yeah, I need to go to Food Lion. That's usually where I tend to see it, is at Food Lion. So like, fingers crossed. I probably should check, since eggnog is starting to pop up in other stores. Because at first I only saw it in Sam's Club and in Target, but I think it's coming out now more. So definitely gotta get my hands on that. Definitely gotta get my hands on some gingerbread Cinnamon Toast Crunch. And that's what this is, Cinnamon Toast Crunch. It also smells like the Life cereal, but the cinnamon version. I feel like we've talked about it, but I don't remember having the candle and putting it in the collection shelf. So I'm just gonna put one just to play it safe. We'll see. And here's another one. Because why just get one? Danger. Coffee and Tonka. Okay, we talked about this one. This is like, it's like a refined Paris cafe. Like it just tickles the soul. Mm-hmm. You know, like Paris cafe is like, I've overindulged in like just wonderfulness. And like this one is like, yes, like I like it's enough. It's like, I don't know. It's like, it doesn't, I feel like when you smell Paris Cafe, it goes up into your nostrils, like all up in your sensory nodes and everything. Like, and it has the power to overwhelm you. And I enjoy the overwhelmness though, because I love that scent. But I feel like the coffee and Tonka, just like, I don't know. It gives it more of like a vibe, like a chiller vibe. Like it's not as loud, proud, and boisterous as the Paris Cafe. So I feel like it has its time and place. But it's a beautiful candle. I really wish that they would come out with it because it was a test candle. And even with it being a test candle, like at the outlet, it was so hard to find. Another one was the patchouli and rosewood, but thankfully they decided to go forward with patchouli and rosewood. So this is my plea to those around the test centers for candles. Like the next time they come out with a coffee one, can y'all just like buy a bunch of them or like, you know, hit your girl up. I'll buy a bunch and you just ship them to me. So then that way Bath & Body Works will go ahead and just make a whole bunch of them. This rosewood, patchouli rosewood, just absolutely beautiful. Also, random side note, I know I said that I was going to try to be fast and make the video short, but I just love talking to you guys and like telling you guys about the craziest like wildness, foolishness that's going on. But on that note, so I don't know if you know, but I am a proud member of the Beehive, although all like she's not doing too well in the press. I'm keeping my eyes open, giving her the side eye, but we're not even going to go into that. But prior to the past 60 days, huge Beehive fan. And so I was like, oh, huge Beyonce fan. And so I ordered the her new perfume. Y'all, I ordered this before we even moved to this house, before we even crossed state lines. And, you know, I don't know if I told y'all, but we had all this drama about our street address, had to get a P.O. box, which is why we have a P.O. box. If you guys want to send us any friend mail, feel free down in the description box or like Christmas cards, anything. We would love and appreciate anything. But yeah, like, I was like, oh man, I can't wait to get my hands on this perfume. And then I got a notice talking about, oh yeah, your perfume, like, it's shipped. And I'm like, okay, so let me check this tracking. Normally I'm good and like, I don't check it and get all riled up, but it was Beyonce. I checked it. What are you talking about? Oh, your shipping label has been created. And so you created the shipping label. And then what? Why haven't you shipped my... Where is my stuff? Where is my perfume? And I'm trying to like stay away from it on TikTok because I stumbled upon someone else like doing a review and was like, oh man, a lot of people are saying it's too much patchouli. And I'm like, how much is too much patchouli? Then I was like, no, I don't want to know. I don't want to know. I don't want to be tainted. So I would really like my Beyonce perfume. But it's not here yet, so I'm gonna impatiently wait for it. Anyways, while I wait, Pure Wonder. Oh, this is, oh my gosh, y'all. When I tell you, when they had the body care sale, when the Pure Wonder fragrance pens were out, y'all, I bought like 25 of them on body care day. Like a fool. But when I tell you, I love those little perfume pens or the little perfume brush with Pure Wonder. Because Pure Wonder, like, you can wear it all the time. It's just, it's so beautiful. Just like a nice, light, airy scent. It's kind of got that like iciness of the winter as well. We're going to put one in the collection shelf. And then I think, yeah, there's, because you know it couldn't just be one. And then we have 1, 2, 3 to go over here for the backup pile. And so, I love Pure Wonder. Pure Wonder is amazing. Also, Open Sky is also amazing. And Open Sky is like a beautiful woodsy scent, but it's not like, it's not too woodsy like Sunrise Woods. Like Sunrise Woods is Sunrise Woods. And it's not super woodsy either, but the wood is there. Whereas with Open Sky, I don't know, it just smells like a beautiful autumn day when the leaves haven't changed. And it's like your weight, like summer, the weather is summer, but like the vibes and the sky are fall. Like, I don't know, like you went to Asheville or something like that in, let's say September, and like it hasn't really cooled down. The leaves are starting to change, but they're not really there. You don't have the cinnamon and the apple orchards just yet. but you know it's coming. That's Open Sky. Beautiful scent. We're going to put one on the collection shelf and then one more in the backup pile. And I think it's interesting. I don't know if you guys saw it on the app, but they are having a little gift box with Pure Wonder, and it comes with like the soap, body care stuff, and these cute little socks. I don't know, like I'm on the fence about it. The only reason why I would purchase it is for the socks, or if like, yeah, that's really the only reason. Cause I already have the candles, and if I want the candle, like I'm pretty sure they would release the candle just being like a regular singular candle, but it might just come out later, like maybe candle day. And so I'm like, it's not really worth it to me to buy the box gift set. But if you were ever interested in Pure Wonder, I mean, and you want some cute little socks, I would say go for it. Have you guys checked the other stuff on the app? Like the gingerbread socks? Y'all already know, I don't care what I gotta do. But when I tell you two pairs of those gingerbread gingham socks will be coming to this here house, or I will be picking it up at a store the day that it comes out, you already know. The ornament holder, I'm like, oh, Vanilla Birch. Y'all know I love Vanilla Birch. And this packaging is so adorable. But the little ornament holder, or the little ornament, it looks cute, but y'all, that thing is tiny, okay? Like, take a second and look at the picture and like look at the, cause at first I wasn't paying attention, and then I looked at the items that were next to it in the picture and I was like, wait a minute, that's a tiny ornament. Is it glass? I mean, because I'm just curious why you want us to pay $16.95 for that tiny little ornament. Oh Lord, here's a little piece of yarn. That's wild. Another Vanilla Birch in here. I'll twirl this around. But yeah, like $16.95 is kind of hefty for an ornament, one. But they know that people who love candles and stuff, they're going to pay for it. And they were smart to put it at $16.95. And these are all backup piles because we just put one in the collection shelf. And there's actually three. Wow, I had a whole thing of it. That's how much I love Vanilla Birch. This was back when I didn't know any better, and I didn't know that Vanilla Birch, 9 times out of 10, it's gonna come out every year. But watch, when I say that and I take it for granted, then they're not gonna bring it back out again and be heartbroken. So that's why I have a bunch. But yeah, I'm just, I don't know. I mean, they were smart to go ahead and make it to be reward price worthy, because like I have no problem with using like two rewards to get to, but if it was like $18.95 or something like that, oh no. there's cinnamon vanilla spice, yeah, it was cinnamon spice vanilla in Paris Cafe. Reading is fundamental, I tell you. One of these days, oh my gosh, y'all. This was such a beautiful blend. Absolutely beautiful. I loved it. I know some people said that it was kind of low throw. This one's going to go in collection shelf. Because I'm remembering one, but I think it was the hot cocoa and cream with the cinnamon vanilla spice. But this one's is different. It's built different because it got my baby Paris Cafe. I think I just have, yeah, there's just more of these, so all these are going to go back up shelf. But I remember when this collection came out, and I was like, oh, it's cute, like, oh, I'm going to try it, and like, some people were like, it's kind of light on the scent, but I felt like whenever I had it, and I was like right over it, because I usually sit at the kitchen table, like, it was just giving me life, and it was giving me like that cinnamon, like, it was like Paris Cafe with a little dash of some, you know, like spicing it up a little bit, like spice it up for me, maybe I'm here for it. And so when they had the SAS sale, which is why I have so many of them, honey, that I was going crazy, okay, when they went like $10 or something again, oh, I was looking for them in the daytime with a flashlight. I was driving all around the triangle to get all of them that I could get, out here placing BOPIS orders like a fiend, because I loved it. And then they came out with the little small one, Cafe in Venice. And it was a single wick. And I feel like it smelled very, like, it smelled exactly like it. And I believe people looked up the scent notes, the fancy, I think it's ILN number, and was like, oh, it's the exact same thing. And it was delicious, absolutely. And it was great to be able to pick it up for free with a reward. So I was like, why not? But of course, you had to, like, light more than one to really get the vibe. But it was fine for free. Hey. Oh wow, here's fresh bamboo. Fresh bamboo will clear up any scent. It will clear your sinuses. Fresh bamboo does not play. So we have more. I remember I bought a couple because they were 75% off. So you know, it, just in case we like, I'm just gonna smell it real quick, but like, just in case we cook up, I don't know, we fry some fish or something like that, and it stinks up the house, we got plenty of fresh bamboo. It is strong. Like, it doesn't smell bad, but it's strong. Okay, this will knock you out, all right? Knock you out. Let's see here. Aw, look at that cute little marshmallow fireside. Ah, it's adorbs. I just love the little gold trees. This one is super cute, but I'm putting the backup pile because I'm like, well, I don't know, y'all. Do y'all think I should put it in the collection shelf? I kind of like the bear just because I'm from New Bern, North Carolina. That's where I grew up, and we were the Bears, so I'm just going to put it in the collection shelf for now. We can change our minds and move it to the backup pile that, you know, we're just going to run through. So here is Fireside. I really enjoy Fireside. It smells so good. It's exactly its namesake. It smells like you are, it smells like you are sitting right next to the fireplace. I really enjoy it. But I can understand why some people aren't really into it, but I don't know. I grew up and with like the Christmas tradition that my dad would always light our wood fireplace downstairs in the, it wasn't like a basement, but it was kind of like we had to go down three sets of stairs, and then it was like my dad's like game room or man cave, if you will. And so that was the one fireplace that had a wood burning fire thing. And so my dad would always light it up on Christmas, and then he would have the Temptations Christmas album playing. So like, it just brings back fond memories. Let's see here. What more do we have? Oh, we have some more Open Sky. I think there's six of them. So I'm just gonna transfer all six of these over here. Open Sky is like, I mean, I don't know what happened. I don't know why they took it away. Like, they just made it randomly disappear. I'm like, we love Open Sky. Come on, now. I'm so happy to see that they're bringing back some of the old school favorites that, like, people are actually interested in. I was going to say, and not so much cucumber melon, but, like, they're still bringing back cucumber melon. And I have to make sure that I remind my mother to pick it up because, like, she's always talking about, oh, they don't have cucumber melon. I'm like, no, it's not the semi-annual. So as soon as the semi-annual sale comes, baby, that's your time. It's your prime time, okay? The next time we have fresh lemon waves. This one is so beautiful. Like, it is just a different take on a lemony scent, and I love it. It's so luxurious. So luxurious. We're going to put it in the backup pile, though, because we talked about it before. Let's see. Oh, Coral Waves. This one was pretty. It's like, it's fruity, but it's not offensive. This one was peach nectar, beachside coconut, and fresh mango. And the mango is not a little musty mango, so we're here for it. And then here is the perfect summer. I really enjoy the perfect summer. It just smells like being out in the sun and having sunscreen on. Like, that's what it does for me. But some people do not care for it. We're going to put all these in the backup pile. And we'll move this over here to the backup pile. this for a collection shelf, and we have three more crates to go through. Oh, Lordy, these things are heavy. All right. Yes. Oh, cuddle weather. Y'all, have we seen cuddle weather this year? I don't recall seeing cuddle weather this year. Now that I think about it, that's sad, because it's like, I don't know, it's like a sweet, like, gingerbready, like, vibe and feeling. And it's sweet, but it's not too sweet. That's why I love it. And the spices. It is warm gingerbread tea, cinnamon shortbread, and a cozy blanket. And that's exactly what it is. And we love that for cuddle weather. And we love that. I'm going to put one in the collection shelf. And then, let's see, we got another one for the backup pile. Yeah, that's crazy. Oh, Give Comfort, Peach on Earth. I liked this one. And now, the peach has a little edge to it. It's not as good as the Aldi, what's the name of that thing? White Peach Cobbler. That is still, hands down, the best peach candle that I've ever experienced in my life. But, like, this one's not bad. It's pretty cool. I have it in this packaging, but it has the orange glass. So I'm going to just put this one in the backup pile because I'd rather have the other one out as the collection one. Another cuddle weather. We're crushing it. And a peach Bellini. I don't even know why I picked up this peach Bellini. Looking like a fool. But I tell you one thing, they ain't got to worry about me picking up another. It's not horrible. It just smells like champagne. And I don't know why, but champagne, like champagne margarita, I enjoy that one because you can like smell the margarita-ness. But the peach Bellini, like, I just don't get it. I don't know. But I'm sorry to anyone who loves peach Bellini. It's nothing personal. It's just not for me. Ooh, yo. Do you know what this is? I'm gonna leave it here and give you a second. If you know what this candle is at whatever time period we are at in this video, please comment down below. And don't be out here cheating now. Don't be like, I'm gonna wait till she shows the candle and then I'm gonna say what it is. Ah! Oh, gosh. I'm gonna rip my little jacket off over here talking trash. Okay. This is a beautiful scent. I absolutely love it. It's amazing. I have not seen this one in a long time either. Oh man, but this little baby right here is Harvest Linen. Yes, you were correct because I believe in you and I feel like you knew which one it was, so good job. And even if you chose the wrong one, it's fine. Good job. You still get participation points. Oh, man. I mean, this is like, it's like taking laundry day to the next level. Between Harvest Linen and Sun-Drenched Linen, they smell different, but like, I don't know. It maybe is just the word harvest. I don't know what it is, but it just gives a different vibe. It's line dried linen, fresh pine, and rich musk. I'm all about some musk, all about some pine, all about some linen. So, oh my gosh. Oh man. No, if they made this in a laundry set, I would fool around and I would order it. And I will order the scent beads, okay? I said it, so maybe they might do it. But yeah, if they came out with Harvest Linen, I would give it a whirl. If on sale, though, on sale, because y'all know it's the principle. It's got to be on sale. But yes, okay, so one for the collection section, and then the rest will go in the backup pile. Oh my gosh. And like, look at the top. That's so adorbs. It's so adorbs. Okay. Let's see. Wow. I feel like this went by like so fast. And I guess because there were so many multiples in this set. I wish that like I knew so I could just do a whole bunch of multiples to get them out of the way for you guys. But like, I literally just like go over there, pick up a couple, put them up here, and then we just go for it. So, oh, frosted coconut snowball. So this one's really interesting. It's coconut. It's not too much coconut. The snowball effect like kind of tones it down. It's got like that wintry iciness. I tried the body care that one year that it came out, and it didn't do it for me, but I love it for other people. If they enjoy it, they like it, I love it. But yeah, I don't know. I'm not a big coconut fan. Speaking of coconut, well, I like to eat coconut. I don't mind smelling like coconut, but it can't be overpowering. Like, it's got to be muted by something else. But, like, there's a hint of coconut there. I know, it's weird. I feel like I'm a high-maintenance fragrance person now. But anyhow, so speaking of coconut, this one, we can keep one for the shelf, but these other two, they back up, and they've got to be warm, and they gotta bounce. So speaking of coconut, I tried that. I don't even know why I'm looking over here, because I know I only purchased one, but I was hoping that it would toggle my memory because all of my soaps are over here. It's like coconut angel cake. I think that's the name of it. But the new scent, y'all, I took it upstairs because I finally finished the soap that was at the kitchen. But I decided to move the skull one from the powder room, put that in the kitchen, because we use up the kitchen hand soap the fastest downstairs. And so then I put the coconut one in the powder room. And so I used it. And it's funny because I was thinking like, oh, I'll pick up some for my mom because there's getting ready to be another hand soap sale soon. Fingers crossed. Allegedly. But if it cut, I was like, oh, I can't get this one because my mom, like, she likes coconut, she likes cucumber melon, and she's very sensitive to smells and can get migraines and stuff. So, like, there's certain ones that she can tolerate. And so I picked up the coconut one. I was like, oh, I'll just try it, you know, just to see. That thing is serious. Okay, I was still smelling coconut on my hands. I was like, no, this is not going to work. But I mean, it's beautiful for people who enjoy coconut. Like, it's a very nice coconut, but then like the bakery scent is still there too. But it's, in my opinion, it's a little overpowering. So yeah, that's not going to make my list for the next soap sale. But I do want to get my hands on the one Philly Girl 31 had, the pink petal tinsel or pink, something pink. Tinsel, but I'm mad that it only comes in the gel form. Like, we really couldn't get a foam soap. Like, we really couldn't expand the formulation and give it to the foam people. Like, I feel like it should be like, whatever scents are made, they should be in gel and the foam form. Like, come on, inclusivity, come on. Anyhow, let's get through these last three candles. So we have the darling, the beautiful, Cedar Suede. Ooh, oh man, would I tell you? Oh, this candle is so, just, oh, so sexy. Too sexy for my candle. Sexy for my candle. It just, it smells so good. It smells so, like, just, oh, it smells like fall, even though it looks like Christmas, but it smells like fall. It's soft cedar, warm incense, and velvety suede. And when I tell you that velvetiness is a velveting, okay? Absolutely amazing. So good that another rumor, alleged sale. I can't remember if we collection shelved this guy. I'm just play safe. We're gonna play safe. I know I have like multiples of this one, so like it's okay, but just put it over here just in case. But when I tell you, I got my hawk eyes out, because as soon as there is a room spray sale, I'm buying this one up, because they made it in a room spray, but like I feel some kind of way using a reward for an $8.95 or a $9.95 product, because I'm like, it's so, like, I'm losing, the loss aversion gets me, and I'm like, I'm going to lose like $6 or $7 that I could have used on something else. But the next time they have a sale, rumor has it, there's one that's going to be coming up soon. Oh, I'm definitely going to get a couple of them. Definitely. Let's see. Oh, Spooky Cider Lane. Do y'all remember when this one came out last year? And like people were acting crazy over this with the little lid, and like people were stealing the lids. Like, it was wild. It was so wild. Actually, speaking of which, ta-da! Here's the lid. So we're gonna put this one here. I'm pretty sure that we have already talked about this one. So I'm gonna put this one in the backup pile. And last but not least, we have Vanilla Snowflake. I'm gonna take this little sticker off. It smells like a vanilla cupcake. It's so pretty. This one, the packaging got a little, it had a little rough go of it, but it's okay. It's cool. We're gonna put this one in the backup pile. And that is it for this. Hopefully the video wasn't too long this time. And I hope that you guys had fun. Yeah, so I guess we will continue on with Candle Chronicles. Y'all, I believe in us. Now, it may be a couple of super long videos, and it's okay if you gotta pause and then carry on. It's okay. But we finna get through all of these candles before Thanksgiving and get our tree up. So I will catch you guys in the next video, and thank you so much for hanging out. If you enjoyed yourself here, please take a hot second to subscribe, because we are on the road to 1,000 subscribers by Christmas. And with that, I will catch you in the next video.